My name is Alice Agogino, and I'm on the Faculty of Mechanical Engineering at UC Berkeley. I run a research lab that has two major directions. The first direction started out with cutting-edge research in artificial intelligence and soft computing. We called ourselves the Berkeley Expert Systems Technology Lab, or the B.E.S.T. Lab for short. In more recent years, we've started projects in energy and sustainable technologies and have an alternate name called the Berkeley Energy and Sustainable Technologies Lab. But regardless, it's the B.E.S.T. Lab, so look us up, best.berkeley.edu. Thought I'd go over a few of the projects that we have in the lab that are current. Engineering education is important to us, and we look at learning apps that are associated with mobile applications, smartphones and augmented realities and educational games. We also do work in a number of projects associated with ergonomics and human-centered design. We also work in design for developing or emerging regions and low-income areas. Projects in this category include reducing pesticide poisoning for farm workers in low-income areas, a project in Africa called the Zambulance, a project to reduce the atmospheric problems associated with cook stoves in a number of areas, including Africa and in Haiti. Another project in Haiti is to make cook stove fuel from agricultural waste in the field, and so we call that fuel from the fields. And then a number of projects associated with water sanitation.
Hi, I'm Ryan Paulson, and I'm just going to tell you a little bit about the motivation behind this project. So buildings use about a third of the total energy in the United States, and 30% of that is lost in the lighting. So if we can more efficiently control the lighting, we can save a lot of energy. So what we've done is we've developed a plug-and-play wireless sensor network and actuation system that is easy to use, personalizable to each user, and customizable to any space.
Hi, I'm Chandri. So one of the major challenges with this research is that, as you see, this office space is a kind of flex space, so the occupancy is very transient, and then you can move around furniture anytime. So there is a lot of uncertainty in the data, and we are using sensor fusion and predictive model to enhance the robustness of our system so that it can work fairly well for a long term.
Hi, my name is Maha. I'm a senior in the Mechanical Engineering Department at UC Berkeley, and I'm part of the Human Powered Gym project that's based in Alice Agogino's B.E.S.T. Lab, and that stands for Berkeley Energy Sustainability and Technologies Lab. The goal of our project is to retrofit the elliptical machines at the recreational sports facility at UC Berkeley so that when users exercise on them, the excess energy is sent back to the electric grid. Another goal of our project is to retrofit a recumbent bicycle so that when you pedal on it, you can charge up a laptop and see the direct implications of human power. We also have a team of undergraduates working on an energy education campaign, so once the ellipticals are retrofit at the gym, we can educate users about energy generating machines and sustainable choices they can make on a daily basis.
Hi, my name is Ryan Shelby. I'm a PhD candidate at UC Berkeley in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, and I'd like to talk to you about the Community Assessment of Renewable Energy Lab here at UC Berkeley under the direction of Professor Alice Agogino. CARE started back in 2007 with Professor Agogino, myself, and Yael Perez, and the goal is to work with local communities to understand how they define and frame sustainability, understand their decision criteria as it relates to sustainability, and most importantly, work with the community members to actually co-design and implement solutions to actually meet their needs. And our cornerstone project is our work with the Pinoleville Pomo Nation of Ukiah, California.
This project started in 2008 when we met with a tribe and decided to do a co-design project in my freshman design and analysis course called E10. We had a module called Human-Centered Sustainable Design. And here's the prototype that the students came up with at the end of the semester, a low-fidelity prototype, but a prototype that had the features that the tribe wanted. And they decided to work on it further in the summer and in future years.
And it's really important. And it's, you've got the community members and the freshman engineering students working together to actually embed their needs and their priorities into this design. So you started off with this low fidelity design, and you've ended up with this high fidelity model right now that we're building.
I'd like to end with saying that I very much value having undergraduate researchers work with all of these projects. I have about 50 undergraduate researchers working with graduate students on these projects. So I hope you will join our lab or learn more about our lab, and maybe I'll see you at Berkeley.